751 TNENS 7680 South SOUT. Check container. Check box 2, proceed from container to CP629629 on main. If AI enter. That's 7951, 7951, 1 box 2.
It's August 25th, 2020, and the end of summer is rapidly approaching us. We're in the small town of Conklin, New York, and the train that we're watching is the southbound Binghamton, New York to Enola, Pennsylvania bound 11Z. Train 11Z and its predecessors are the historical straight lines that we've been following since I started this channel. Over the years, 11Z has gone through many changes and incarnations, which even included at one time being a night train. The biggest change made to the Z is that today it can routinely exceed 10, 11, and even 12,000 feet since it now encompasses elements of the former 36T train that used to go to Allentown. Today's leader, locomotive number 7688, is a General Electric ES-44 DC model that was built in November of 2007 and placed in service the very next month in December. It's one of about 207 on the road, and like many GEs, it was originally a 4,000 horsepower diesel that was beefed up to its intended 4,400 horsepower in around 2015. It's a relatively lightweight loco weighing in at around 410,000 pounds, unlike its newer AC-powered cousins, which are heavily ballasted at 432,000 pounds. The 7688 is also one of the handful of DC Gevos that came factory painted, unlike many Grey Ghost diesels of that era. It's equipped for electronically pneumatic train braking and has automatic engine stop and start. Like many locomotives, the 7688 had shown up in the region before. Last time I caught it was on the northbound train 11A out of Northumberland back around 2018. And as you can tell by the many specialty flat cars, this is no ordinary train 11A. I'll explain why in another video.
Folks, southern mile post.
Jessup is a small coal mining town nestled in the valley along the original Delaware and Hudson Penn Division main line, now the Delaware-Lackawanna-Carbondale main line that got a big boost when a new power plant was constructed there in 2017. This saw high and wide shipments moving on NS and DL trains by the dozens. The DL shoves the loads to Hill Street in Jessup, where they're transloaded off of the flat cars and onto special land barges that I like to call centipedes. From Hill Street, the loads move several miles on the streets of Jessup until they reach their final destination, which is a large power plant just outside of town. This plant, like all or at least most, will be fueled by natural gas and is predictive of where the energy industry is headed. Movements of this scale is obviously not something done during the peak hours of daylight and is of such interest to spectators that it's broadcasted weeks in advance, as shown here by the Jessup Ambulance Station. Once the delivery is made, the light engines return north to Binghamton, New York, and their next waiting assignment.
Do a 5-4.
And that's how the story goes of how those specialized flat cars ended up on the manifest of Train 11A. I'll be breaking down the rest of this train in parts 2 and 3. So until then, stay tuned.